Happy Sunday. Welcome. Before we begin the Mass, please adjust your cell phones to silent mode. The Lord always invites us to come to Him. Let us joyfully respond to His invitation to experience His love at all times. In this Mass, we pray for all the needs of the members of our parish family and concerns of the whole world, for the Thanksgiving anniversary prayers of Juan and Lorna Balisa-Lisa, and Thanksgiving prayer of the Mercator family and Chito and Maricel Garcia. For all our brothers and sisters who need the grace of healing, and for all those who care for them. And for our departed brothers and sisters, Virginia de la Cruz Cristobal, Paz Das Marinas, Christian Rafael Ortanez, Virginia Lau, Carmencita Ibud, Lydia Lopez, Francisco Edkid, Glenda Flores Feria, and all those who have died due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Let us all rise for the entrance hymn, number 414, All Are Welcome.
Happy Sunday to all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the 14th Sunday in ordinary time. And the Lord Jesus invites us to feel the joy in our hearts and also be aware of who He really is, that He is our strength, that He is the life that we have, and through His Spirit, we are happy in journeying this life, even though sometimes we are challenged and we also fail. So recognizing our failures, let us now come to Him for mercy and forgiveness, that we can give our all in worship. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory, glory.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Extol you, O my God and King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever.
I will praise your name.
is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is faithful in all his words, and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling, and raises up all who are bowed down. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus Christ. I believe we discover in life that the thing we really long and desire is to be happy or to be joyful. And we can see this in every stage of life. For the children, they would like to be happy, and most of the things that made them happy is to have toys. And they are not contented of one toy, but they have what? Lots of toys. And for the younger ones, the youth, their joy is more on their friends. That's why sometimes parents are being challenged by them, because they would like to spend more time with their friends, and that they cannot go with life without their what? Smartphones, because through them they can connect with friends. And for the adults, their joy is sometimes good in many ways. To those who would like to settle down with their loved ones that they would like to marry and have a union in the sacrament of marriage. And if they are not yet, they are to discover their own life with people that they care and love. They have the so-called relationship. So this is also true with God. God wants us to realize that joy and happiness are really the things we need in life. Thus, for God, He gave us the things that would help us attain this goal. However, in doing this, there are times that we are being challenged to the point that we are being burdened. And because of this, we feel not being happy, not being joyful. And there are those who are discouraged about it. So this Sunday, through the Word of God, God invites us not to be discouraged, but to hopefully be encouraged. And we can see this in the first reading from the book of Prophet Zechariah. God asked Zion and Jerusalem to rejoice heartily, to shout for joy. And this is being reinforced in the second reading by the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, that we have to be aware that we are not just people of the flesh, but we also are people in the Spirit. And the Spirit that we are talking about is the Spirit of Christ. And why we have this kind of spirit? Because through Christ, we can see the real path on how to be happy or joyful. He offered us three things to look at. For Christ, path to happiness is to maintain our faith in God, to pray. The gospel that we proclaim started with a prayer. Christ was praising the Father because he revealed the things to the little ones, although he hid it from the learned and the wise. He was talking to the Father. He was conversing to the Father. And this is what prayer is, to converse with God. And we know the importance of conversation or communication in our dealing with one another. It builds connection. It bands us together. Second, relationship. I mentioned this a while ago. Jesus tried to point out the idea of knowledge. Only Son knows the Father, and only the Father knows the Son, and those to whom the Son would like to reveal him. In relationship, we can see the fullness of the person. In relationship with God, we can learn Him more. And the moment we learn Him more, we always know and realize that we are in His good hands. And because of this, we cannot but just be happy and joyful. Because what we need can be given by Him. And the third, openness. Because the moment we know God, then, as I mentioned just a few minutes ago, we know who He is. He is truly a just and loving God. A God who invites us all the times. A God that who realizes that we sometimes are burdened, but the burden we have is not heavy, it's light. And He always invites us to come to Him. And in fact, we come to Him today. In the celebration of the Mass, we gather around the table set to be with Him. Hopefully, we can always remember these three things so that we can grow and move forward in following the path of happiness and joy that we can see in prayer. We can connect with God. In our relationship with Him, this connection would be strengthened. And when challenged, we can come to Him for strength, for compassion, for mercy, and forgiveness. Because in Him, we know He is the source of the things we need in the journey. I believe in one God, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, true God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism, forgiveness of sin. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As Christ invites us to come to him, let us now bring our needs and prayers to him.
For the Pope, as leader and shepherd of the Church, may the Lord bless him in his work of encouraging people to come to the Lord, to be relieved of unnecessary burdens, and to find rest for their souls. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the millions of people, including children, in our own and other countries, who are trapped and forced in unpaid work, sexual exploitation, bonded labor, and various forms of slavery and human trafficking today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For people with heavily burdened lives, for those with great responsibilities, and the demanding care of others, and all who are worried and stressed. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who are sick, especially the ones we pray in this Mass, those who feel burdened, confined in hospitals and residential care, and for those who love and care for them, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the Thanksgiving anniversary prayers of Juan and Lorna Valesilasa, and Thanksgiving prayers for the Merced family and Chito and Marcel Garcia. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our parish family, that we may continue to support one another, to grow in faith, hope, and love, to build the body of Christ in this community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For all the faithful departed, Virginia de la Cruz Cristobal, Paz Tasmarinas, Virginia Lau, Camencita Ibad, Eduardo Taylor Buromeo, Christian Rafael Ortanez, Lydia Lopez, Francisco Esqui, Glenda Flores Feria, and those who have died due to the COVID-19 pandemic, that they may find rest for their souls and be led rejoicing through the gates of paradise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our own personal intentions, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. Together we pray. Lord Jesus, through the sacrament of baptism, you give us new life and make us members of the body, the Church. Grant, we pray, the stewards of gifts and blessings, we build a permanent church where great faith, guidance, and joy to Christ our Lord. Amen. Mater Dei,
pray for us.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced in a life and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other our smile of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy, yes, only my Lord, but only see the world, my soul shall be. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our parish prayer, Almighty Father, the body of Christ, the Church, is made up of people who believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, and save to his suffering, death, and resurrection. Enable us to grow in faith, hope, love, and service, that we may build a welcoming, friendly faith community, a community that is your Son's life and mission. After the life example of Mary, Mother of God, Mater Dei, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mater Dei. Please be seated.
Church construction update. If you wish to see our church construction progress, please visit our parish website, moderndaycv.org. Thank you. Through email, the church dedication invitation has already been sent. Please respond accordingly to this invitation by today, July 5th, 2020. Due to the limited number of people allowed in the church to worship during this time of pandemic, we can only accommodate 2 persons from each family on a first-come, first-served basis. In the event that the allowed number of persons in the church is reached, the overflow will be seated in the pastoral center or in the gathering areas and parish office parking lot. A notification will be sent to you about seating location. For the benefit of everyone to join and participate in this solemn and momentous celebration, the entire church dedication mass will be streamed live on our parish website at moderndaycv.org. Let's celebrate the joy of having a new and permanent church. To our parish family, we thank you for building our life of faith, stewardship, and sacrifice. We also thank all our friends and visitors in worshiping with us. It is our great joy to have you. To become fully part of our parish family, you may register to the parish after Mass. We have ministers to assist you.
Thank you all for making the time to attend in this Mass, and to all the ministers serving in this Mass, thank you so much for your ministry. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.